Well, guess what? It's, you know, dinner time in the High household. And what better way to have dinner than with a couple tinned fishes? Today we have three from the same brand, Briosa brand, Briosa Gourmet, that is. Yeah, it's your standard trio of olive oil, small, and spiced. Cool. So I think the small ones are gonna be interesting, so I'm gonna save those for last. Let's go easy. Let's go starter with just your standard olive oil. This is also a product of Portugal. The last sardines I had were the Gonçalves brand, also Portugal. So we're looking at a pretty big price hike from there to here, from the same area. So I think we're about to find out if we're buying more quality with Briosa or just a name brand. Let's quit yapping and just get this paper open, huh? It's taped on pretty good. This is like when my grandma would wrap gifts just so perfectly, so precisely. She would always have me put my finger down to hold the paper in place while she got the tape ready. That was the input that I had of the wrapping each Christmas. There's a high quality to this paper. That's what I'm noticing right now. This is like a matte finished paper. This isn't no Kinko's. This isn't no FedEx office. This is a special order. However, once the paper's off, we're just looking at a can. Just a normal can. Let's eat. Right away, I'm noticing not much of an oil bubble. Some cans, you pull that tab back and the oil just bubbles straight out. Wow, I got four of them in here. I think that's standard. I think I'm learning that that's a standard number to have. Some weight to these babies. They're actually thicker. I think they're thicker boys. I think they're little thick boys. These are beautiful. I got nothing left to say, so I'm eating it. Oh mama. That oil is silky smooth. I would rub myself in that oil. Wow. You know what? I kind of felt like I was just being marketed to with this nice matte finished paper and the price hike. I thought they'd be exactly the same, but these are just primo. These are out of control. Oh man. It's hard to pinpoint exactly what it is that's making them so much better. I think it's a combination of many small upgrades. I think the oil is a better quality. I think the fish is firmer. There's much more to chew in this stuff. Less mushy. The oil even has like sort of a bronze, sort of a golden tone to it, more so than the last one. I think it's a much higher quality oil. I think I'm chalking it up so far to the oil. The skin is beautiful. Wow. Can you catch that glimmer? Goodness. These are the highest quality I've had so far. Delicious. Out of control. On to the next. Wow, you know what? I was so excited about that last one that I forgot I had spiced ones. I feel like these can only be an upgrade. A little bit of spice on just about anything will set it apart from even the best of a non-spiced version, I think. Too easy. Oh boy. Let's see, how are they spiced? We got sardines, olive oil, chili pepper, cucumber, carrot, pepper seed, clove, and salt. That is the exact ingredient profile as the spiced Gonsalves brand. Oh. Oh, that one bubbled out a little. That might be just user, you know? Not necessarily error, but I think that happens because of the user. I love how fat these babies are. These are little chunguses. Little humunguses. There's something to that. There's a stink. And it's a very positive stink. Not like that mackerel. Whoops. Wow. That's really good. I have a complaint. I'm just gonna get it out of the way. Pretty scaly. A lot of scale action. I don't care. I mean, I'll say it one more time. Scale city. I'm in swimming in an ocean of scales. But the flavor is just out of control good. It overshadows the scale situation hugely. Oh wow, look at the dark skin on this one. That makes me feel like maybe this guy's like, he's a little wiser, you know? He's a little more aged. Maybe he's like a senior citizen sardine. Mmm. I'm just gonna open them up a little. Wow. Look at that. Look at how many bones. I had no idea there were that many bones. Got some gorgeous flesh. Springy. Let's see if I can get a spine out. I'm gonna eat just a spine like Matt does. I'm not gonna just eat a clove. I'm gonna be honest, I kinda wish I had had these small sardines in olive oil before the spicy ones, because I don't think these are gonna match up. And it would have been nice to just go, you know, start at the bottom, go all the way up to the mountain, but I feel like I'm gonna do this. I started at the bottom, and then I went to the peak, and now I'm about to go to like a semi-peak. I'm sure there's a technical term for that. So these are simple. Just sardines and olive oil with salt. However, they're small. And I have a feeling that these small sardines are gonna pack some big flavor. It's like becoming my mission now to try to open it without letting the oil bubble out. Ooh. Wow. Look at all these. So they only fit three fatties in the last can. Right now I'm looking at 9 skinny boys. Wow. That's definitely small. It's definitely a tiny little Dean. You know what? That tastes very different from a full sizer. So I guess this is basically like the veal of like the Dean world, right? And I gotta say, I don't think the flavors have matured enough. I don't know, there's something weird about it. There's like somewhat of a artificial taste to it. But it's just Dine's and oil, so that can't be. The texture is lights out. Texture's killing me. It's great. But the flavor, I don't know, there's just something to it. Seems off. It's like an artificial cherry flavor or something, which is definitely odd. Yeah, you know, I don't know if I'd get these ones again. I'm gonna try something crazy. I'm bringing the spicy oil back into the mix and see what happens if I do this and see if this upgrades it. Take a little bath, Dini boy. Wash away your artificial sins. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That kind of worked. They're definitely pretty. I'll give them that.